Meet Ed Yoder. He's an active tinkerer who loves his dog, Toby. He's also a guy who likes to get things done, like mowing the lawn. But his pet stake in the yard always seemed to be in the way and slowing things down.
Huh? It was always an aggravating thing that, you know, I gotta pull this stake out to mow it. Most of the time I wouldn't pull a stake out. I didn't take it out and have to put it back in. I wanted a pet stake different than any other pet stake. I went out to the local tractor place to try to find one. The girl there taking care of that section, I told her I want a pet stake that's below ground so I don't stumble over it. And she says, well, if you think you're so smart, why don't you invent one? That's all she needed to say.
Ed wants a new kind of dog tether. You know, one that he doesn't yank out every time he has to go mow the grass.
Since people have owned dogs, there's been a need to tether them outside for exercise and for other doggy-type activities when we're busy. The point is, we don't want our furry friends to run away, get hit by cars, or end up in our neighbors' yards. Our mission is to create a better tether device for Ed and his dog, Toby.
I absolutely relate to it. In fact, I've actually hit a stake in the backyard with my lawnmower. Actually, I hit it with my wheel instead of the blade.
Jason got the nod for Ed's idea. His team had to invent a pet stake that was easy to use, cost-effective to make, and appealing to consumers.
Through our process, we decided, well, we'll marry up a bowl with a standard-style stake that you're familiar with, everyone has seen in the store. So we just went along with something that's already manufactured for ease and simplicity and cost savings.
The team came up with a design that takes a standard pet stake and surrounds it with a cone that has a hole in the bottom for drainage, and then you screw it down into the ground so someone can mow over it.
Originally, we presented this product to Fuzzbutt Marketing, and Fuzzbutt came back. They were kind of lukewarm, so-so. That led us to eventually presenting the product to Hugs several weeks later, and as soon as Hugs saw the item, they were ready to move on it right away.
During our meeting with the Hugs Pet Company, an executive said, "What about food and water?"
One of the big problems that dogs have when they're tied up or tethered up is they knock their water bowl over and they knock their food bowl over. I had the distinct pleasure of going back to Jason and his team and letting him know that, hey, we gotta go back to the drawing board and start over.
It really doesn't matter what I think. The whole thing is that it is accepted on the market and it sells.
So the team had to go back to work and redesign Ed's idea to not only solve his problem, but also resolve the food and water problem.
Someone said, well, whenever you put the stake through the bowl, there's a hole in the bottom of the bowl. All the water will drain out. And we said, well, it's not a water bowl. It's just to hold the stake to keep you from running over with your lawnmower. And then we were like, wait a minute.
The answer was right under their noses. The cone was redesigned in the shape of a two-sided dog bowl that screws into the ground. The world's first humane dog bowl tether had been invented. Before we sent the design to Hugs, we of course had to properly test it.
Hey, Clay.
Hey, what's up?
Need your help with something.
Okay.
We're working on a project called the Better Tether.
Okay.
And when we thought about testing this, we said, how are we gonna test this and try to get into the head of a dog? That's where you come in.
Really?
Really. I'll see you outside. Okay, Clay, so here's the deal. We got you dressed up on a beautiful sunny day. You can spend your afternoon outside, okay? Got a dog bowl. I have a leash strapped to a regular old tether like everybody has at home. Hook you up. Okay.
Thank you.
And we have this costume.
Yeah, well.
Dogs don't have thumbs.
No.
We have to. We got to keep it real. I don't want you unhooking yourself.
You know, technically speaking, a dog has the option of going to the bathroom at any time that they want.
You have that option as well. Well, good luck and happy testing.
Yeah.
Just be a dog, Clay.
Okay.
Just be a dog.
Listen, I.
Okay.
Hey, my water fell over already. Hey! Hey, hey! Hey, 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 hey! What are you looking at?
Okay, Clay, time for phase two. You look like a thirsty puppy. Clay. Clay, come on, boy. Come on, boy. You okay? Ready for a drink, I bet, huh? What do you think of that? Okay. Yeah, he was definitely relieved when I came up with a better tether. He was thirsty. I gave him a new bowl that wouldn't spill, filled it with nice cold water. He's a happy puppy.
Ed's idea went into production with Hugs, and it was ready for the store shelves.
Jason's team did a great job of taking Ed's original problem, Hugs' feedback, and incorporating them all into a final design.
I thought to myself, oh my God, somebody likes it.
With a better tether on its way to becoming a success, we invited Ed to Invention Land for a special treat.
Well, there you go. You saw it on paper. Now it's for real.
I couldn't have done it better myself.
Clover, come here, girl.
Good girl.
Yeah, you know what goes in that bowl, don't you?
Let's see what we got here.
Oh, hold on. I think this might be for you.
Oh, is that right? Something I could eat.
Nice little surprise. It's your first royalty check, Ed.
Wow.
Congratulations.
That is a surprise. $11,000.
For us, that's a really rewarding experience. And in Ed's situation, I would say it was particularly rewarding. He had some people who didn't believe in his idea. He did it. He pulled it off. And I'm glad that we could help him do that.
Well, I tell you, that's a great feeling. I'm really proud that I invented a more humane way to tie up your pet outside. I know that I'm in the last chapter of the book, and that's good to know that. I did it mostly so that I can make a little mark, just a small man like me, make a little mark in life.